Washington introduced a new draft resolution at the UN Security Council proposing further sanctions on North Korea. During the vote on the proposal, China and Russia are not expected to use their vetoes this time around.
Japan welcomes the unanimous adoption of Resolution 2397. We would like to express our great appreciation to the leadership of the United States, which made this possible. We also thank all other members of the Community Council for their support. At the ministerial meeting on the 15th of December, over which Foreign Minister Kono presided, the Security Council made it clear to the world that the international community will never accept a nuclear-armed North Korea.
The UN Security Council will vote Friday local time on a new US-led draft resolution on North Korea that has been introduced in reaction to the regime's latest ballistic missile test in late November. According to Reuters and AFP, the new resolution will look to ban nearly 90% of refined petroleum product exports to North Korea by capping them at 500,000 barrels a year, building on the previous resolution in September that set a limit of 2 million barrels. Crude oil exports to the regime have also been capped at 4 million barrels a year. All North Korean nationals working overseas will also have to be repatriated within 12 months, and the list of banned North Korean exports will be extended to include food products, machinery, and electrical equipment, as well as certain stones and minerals. 19 individuals and firms would be added to a growing international blacklist as well, freezing their financial assets and imposing a travel ban. North Korea's closest ally, China, is not expected to use its veto after the US negotiated the draft with Beijing over the past week, although it does not include a complete ban on oil, as suggested by President Trump to President Xi Jinping last month. China's go-ahead would still be seen as a significant measure. More so, as China has not yet approved a different proposal by the US. Washington had asked the Council to blacklist 10 ships, including two Hong Kong flag vessels and a Chinese tugboat, which are said to be carrying banned oil and coal products to and from North Korea. China and Russia have requested more time to examine that proposal, and the decision for approval to blacklist the ships will now take place on December 28th.
Today, by adopting Resolution 2397, the Security Council sends a clear signal to North Korea that continuation of their nuclear and missile development can never be tolerated, including the third and longest ever launch of ballistic missiles with a range of an ICBM on the 29th of November. Resolution 2397 will further strengthen the sanctions measures against North Korea, which were already at an unprecedented level. The new impactful measures include reduction of refined petroleum cap by 89% since January this year, commitment to future oil reductions in case of North Korea's further provocations, repatriation of all North Korean workers within 24 months, and additional restrictions of export and import with North Korea. Today's resolution exemplifies the serious collective will of the international community that we will continue to put maximum pressure on North Korea until it shows seriousness and takes concrete actions towards the goal of denuclearization. In this regard, operative paragraph 28 of the resolution clearly states that the Council, and I quote, shall keep the DPRK's actions under continuous review and is prepared to strengthen, modify, suspend or lift the measures as they may be needed in light of the DPRK's compliance, unquote. Operative paragraph 28 also clearly states that, and I quote again, if the DPRK conducts a further nuclear test or a launch of a ballistic missile system capable of reaching international ranges or contributing to the development of a ballistic missile system capable of such ranges, then the Security Council will take action to restrict further the export to DPRK of petroleum, unquote. Let me reiterate again that North Korea can make a choice toward a peaceful, diplomatic solution. If North Korea wants peace and security, it needs to demonstrate its sincere commitment and concrete measures for the denuclearization of the Korean Peninsula, comply fully with the relevant Security Council resolutions and joint statements of the six-party talks, and come back to the meaningful dialogue table. in order to make North Korea realize the determination of the international community to achieve the denuclearization of the Korean Peninsula, all members of the United Nations must renew their commitment to fully implement the existing Security Council resolutions, including 2371, 2375, and the resolution just adopted today. Japan looks forward to continuing to work closely with relevant partners and all other member states to reach a comprehensive solution to the problems related to North Korea.
South Korea and Japan pledged to continue working closely together to tackle the North Korean nuclear issue. Seoul's foreign ministry said Friday that the envoys of both sides met in Tokyo to reiterate the need to try and resolve the situation peacefully and continue the sanctions and pressure campaign until the regime is ready to give up its nukes. Lee Do-hoon stressed the importance of maintaining the safety of the peninsula, especially in light of the upcoming Pyeongchang Winter Games, which South Korea has dubbed the Peace Olympics. His Japanese counterpart, Kenji Kanasugi, expressed his hopes for a peaceful and successful global games and promised further cooperation and efforts to denuclearize the communist state.
Mr. President, let me begin by thanking you, Mr. President, for convening today's meeting to follow up on our discussion about 3 weeks ago in response to North Korea's launch of ballistic missile on 29th of November. I also very much appreciate your invitation to this important meeting. Mr. President, exactly 1 week ago, and right here in this chamber, delegations and representatives from 16 countries, including my own, reiterate our condemnation of DPRK's provocative behavior as being one of the most serious threats to international peace and security, as well as a flagrant violation of the relevant Security Council resolutions. We also reaffirmed our unwavering commitment to the denuclearization of the DPRK. The stark contrast that we witnessed last Friday between the DPRK representative and the rest of the Council revealed once again how isolated the regime is and how unconvincing its claims have been. We international community must continue to stay united and demonstrate our resolute determination to the DPRK that a nuclear North Korea will never be recognized, and that if it keeps on going down this path, there will be continue to be consequences. In this context, the Republic of Korea welcomes and fully supports the adoption of Security Council Resolution 23 and 97, which introduces robust measures that build upon and tighten the existing sanctions against the DPRK. I would like to thank each and every member of the Council, including the United States, for their hard work to unanimously adopt this resolution. Taking this opportunity, I wish to emphasize loud and clear the importance of seamless and complete implementation. The Republic of Korea remains committed to supporting any other member state in its effort to fully and effectively implement all relevant resolutions, including this resolution adopted today. Mr. President, I wish to draw your attention to a view widely shared by the participants at last week's Security Council Ministerial meeting. Sanctions are not an end in themselves, but an effective means to bring North Korea back on the track for a peaceful, diplomatic, and political solution. However narrow and bumpy it may be, the road toward peaceful denuclearization through dialogue is still open and available. The ROK government urged the DPRK to participate in the Pyeongchang Winter Olympic Games and stop its destabilizing provocations in the lead up to the Olympics of Peace. I sincerely hope the DPRK will take this message seriously and seize the opportunity to create a conducive atmosphere for sincere dialogue toward denuclearization. The DPRK should abandon the delusional idea of pursuing security through developing illegal nuclear weapons and ballistic missiles. Instead, it should engage in constructive dialogue and redirect its effort to deliver prosperity and a better livelihood to its people. The choice is up to the DPRK. I thank you, Mr. President.
With North Korea's latest test of its Hwasong-15 ICBM in November, the world was left speculating what its next move would be. A South Korean think tank has attempted to provide some answers. In its report, Outlook on International Affairs for 2018, the Institute of Foreign Affairs and National Security says the biggest task left for the regime is to perfect its missile technology, with the remaining parts being re-entry technology.
A successful missile launch must have three things: launch trajectory, position control, and re-entry. North Korea's missiles currently have the first two, but not re-entry.
But why is re-entry technology so important?
Re-entry is what allows a nuclear warhead to withstand extreme heat and pressure when passing through the Earth's atmosphere. Without it, the missile would not be able to drop nuclear weapons onto its target area. That's why it's so important.
The expert added that there are two possible scenarios for the future. One, North Korea doesn't succeed in its re-entry technology next year, in which case they will continue testing ICBMs. But the second scenario is what's drawing the most attention. If they do succeed, they will most likely seek disarmament talks with the United States.
North Korea will most likely demand to be recognized as a nuclear state and to keep a certain level of nuclear technology in exchange for limiting their ICBM capabilities enough to attack neighboring countries.
The expert added that the timeline in which this would happen could vary from a few months to a few years, but it is only a matter of time, and when that time comes, the U.S. and the regime's neighboring countries such as South Korea and Japan must decide on how to respond to North Korea's request to be recognized as a nuclear state. Lee Jong-yeon, Arirang News.